Congratulations on graduation. Your hard work paid off. Best wishes on your future endeavors. Cheers to an amazing college journey.
First of all, I want to say thank you to my family and my friends. And guys, congratulations, we did it.
Alhamdulillah, we're finally here. I want to thank Mama for being the main reason I'm able to graduate today. I want to thank Papa for always believing in me and Josefa for being the best brother anyone could ever ask for. Lastly, I want to thank Dali, Dada, Naina, all my relatives and friends for helping me grow throughout my time here at Stony Brook. Go Sea Wolves.
My name is Kimberly Liu. I'm a BSMD student. I would like to thank all my professors who taught me so much these past 3 years, especially Dr. Falich, Dr. Simon, Dr. Singh, Dr. Arola, and Dr. Kachoka. Good luck to all 2021 graduates.
Thank you to Anthony, my parents, my friends and family, and all the professors. Congrats, class 2021. We did it.
Welcome, everyone. My name is Peter Gergen, and as the director of the program in undergraduate biology at Stony Brook University, it is my distinct honor to welcome you all and officially open this year's departmental virtual convocation ceremony, honoring the biochemistry and biology graduates in the Stony Brook University class of 2021. Welcome to all the graduates that have joined us today. Congratulations from the undergraduate biology program and from the departments of biochemistry and cell biology, ecology and evolution, and neurobiology and behavior. You did it. I would like to also welcome all the family members and friends of our graduates who are here to celebrate with us today. We all know how important you have been in helping our graduates reach this moment, especially with the many unprecedented challenges of the past 15 months. You should be extremely proud of your graduates and know they appreciate your love and support. So now to our graduates. You are all certainly aware of the work that you've put in to get to this day, but I would like to make sure that our guests appreciate your accomplishments. Our biology and biochemistry graduates will be receiving degrees from two of the most rigorous and respected undergraduate degree programs at Stony Brook University. As alumni of Stony Brook, this group of graduates will be alumni of one of the premier public research universities in the United States and will have earned a degree that is respected worldwide. This respect is not just handed out, but is achieved through hard work. More than 650 new freshmen came to Stony Brook as majors in biochemistry and biology in the fall of 2017. The students here today are the ones who put in the work to make it to the finish line. They can tell you that some of their freshman friends, approximately one third of those who started on this path, are not here, but opted instead for a different major. These survivors are joined by a cadre of students who came to Stony Brook as transfer students and also put in the work to cross the finish line. Indeed, the successful transfers students account for approximately 25% of the 533 students that have applied for graduation in biochemistry or biology this May or August. Not to brag on our graduates too much, but they are amongst the best and brightest at Stony Brook. The life sciences faculty at Stony Brook frequently hear from colleagues in other departments that the very best students in their classes are the biology and biochemistry students. This is not a statement just made in passing, but is borne out by evidence. I would like to share some of this evidence with you as we honor some of the outstanding accomplishments of this group of graduates. Every year, the Chancellor's Award recognizes a select set of undergraduates who best demonstrate the integration of academic performance with other aspects of university and community life from across all the campuses of the State University of New York system. This year, each SUNY campus was allowed to nominate 3 students for this award. One of the 2 Stony Brook students selected to receive the Chancellor's Award is one of our graduating biology majors, Erica Nemeth. Stony Brook University Provost Award is given annually to a select number of graduating seniors who have shown true academic excellence, not just in the classroom, but in other ways, as well as in research or creative activities or in building an academic community. I'm pleased to inform you that 5 of the 14 undergraduates selected to receive the Provost Award for academic excellence are graduating as biochemistry or biology majors. Phi Beta Kappa is a national honor society devoted to the promotion of scholarly attainment in liberal arts and sciences. Election Phi Beta Kappa is based not only on high grades, but also on the breadth and balance in the candidates program. 18 of this year's biochemistry and biology graduates have been elected to Phi Beta Kappa. This group accounts for 31% of this year's class of Phi Beta Kappa graduates. Degrees of distinction are conferred upon candidates for the Bachelor of Science who have completed at least 55 credits at Stony Brook and obtained the requisite grade point average in the class. The distinction of cum laude is awarded to students with a grade point average of 3.50 or higher. The distinction of magna cum laude is awarded to students with a grade point average of 3.7 or higher, and the distinction of summa cum laude is awarded to students with a grade point average of 3.85 or higher. A total of 231 of the current group of biology and biochemistry graduates are eligible for graduating with a degree of distinction. If you remember that the denominator was 533 students that applied to graduate this May and August, then more than 40% of the biology and biochemistry students are graduating with distinction. Finally, one aspect of our convocation ceremony that we sincerely regret not being able to celebrate in person today are recognizing those students who will be graduating with honors in biochemistry or biology. Graduation with honors in biochemistry or biology requires both a record of outstanding academic achievement as well as the completion of an honors thesis based on an independent research project. Our honors graduates typically receive a framed certificate that is presented by their faculty research sponsor during our departmental convocation each May. Completion of an honors thesis was especially challenging for this year's graduates, as nearly all in-person research on campus, with the exception being the research on COVID-19, was suspended from March to June last year, and all undergraduate research was done remotely from the middle of March until last fall. In this context, I am really proud to give this virtual recognition to both the students as well as the faculty advisors. Our 6 biochemistry honors degree graduates: Navid Ashrafi, Lexin Chen, Jose Guerra, Ananya Iyengar, Jordan Rowland, and Sydney Sirota. And finally, it is with great pleasure to now give virtual recognition to the 14 biology honors degree graduates: Scott Fiala, Bismarck Obosu Frimpong, Nina Gu, Adana Ibeku, Anisha Javeji, Minu Junkadi, Jocelyn Kaur, Sultan Kaur, Kimberly Liu, Erica Nemeth, Laura Roche, Ella Sachs, Ariel Shade, and William Zhang. Let me now conclude my opening welcome by giving all of our graduating students a hearty congratulations, a congratulations that I'm pleased to now share with some of my faculty colleagues.
Hello, graduates.
One last Bio 203 question.
Just kidding.
Congratulations.
Hey.
Yay.
Congratulations. You completed your bachelor's degree. Your journey up to this point has had many hurdles, and I can imagine at any point during your training that you often felt like a circus performer trying to maintain a group of spinning plates. Well, I hope that you'll be able to look back on your undergraduate experiences with a smile, be able to chuckle at your shortcomings, and embrace your successes. Be sure to come back and visit and keep me posted on what you're doing. So long.
Hi, everyone. This is Nancy Hollingsworth from Bio 320. I want to give my congratulations to the class of 2021. You know, the last 2 years of college are hard because you're taking upper division level classes now, and you all had to deal with the extra difficulty of having those classes go suddenly online due to the pandemic. So I just want to applaud you for your resilience and your persistence and succeeding despite that adversity. And I just wish you all the best in your future activities.
Oh, graduates, congratulations. You've done it. Wow. What a tough year this has been. And what a remarkable achievement getting through this year and finishing and graduating. Congratulations. It's been a great pleasure knowing those of you who I've gotten to know. And I wish you the very, very best in the future. May the wind be at your back, as they say, and hope everything goes well for you in the future. It's been quite a year. It's been a privilege to share this difficult time with you. So very best wishes.
Congratulations, graduates. Enjoy your special day. And wherever you go and whatever you do, I'm wishing you the very best of luck. And I hope
Hi, this is Dr. Scher.
Hello, this is Dr. Shelley.
And we'd like to congratulate all of the graduates and wish you a wonderful graduation day from Bio 317 and the Department of Neurobiology.
Congratulations to the class of 2021. A shout out to the students who took bioinformatics and evolution. You are awesome. And a special thanks to undergrad TAs Jose and Priya. And a very special shout out to the truly amazing undergraduate researchers in my lab, Nina, Jordan, Whitney, and Priya. I don't know how I got so lucky to get to work with you. You are dedicated, talented, smart, and persistent. Thank you for your hard work. You have very bright futures ahead of you. Congratulations to all the graduates.
Hi, congratulations to all you graduates, and especially to those of you who took Bio 320 remotely and Bio 335 in person. You did really well in two tough courses under trying conditions. And we really appreciated how well all of you coped with all the difficulties of the past year and are grateful for the support and the understanding that you showed us. Stony Brook students are the best. We know it. Now you go tell the world.
Thank you to all my faculty colleagues for these words of congratulations and encouragement. Now it is time to hear from some of our current graduates. Take it away, guys.
Hey.
Hey, what's up?
Oh my God, I am so ready for graduation. Where are we with the speech?
I'm basically done with my part. Srishti, you're on mute right now.
Am I still muted?
No, you're good now.
Oh. Oh my God, I am so done with Zoom. Do y'all want to meet on campus?
Yeah, sure. Is everybody vaccinated?
Yep, got Pfizer.
I got Moderna.
Me too.
Awesome, let's meet up on campus.
All right, I'll be there in 10.
You mean that, like 30? I don't want to look like
this. Okay.
Class.
All right, see you guys.
All right, bye.
Good evening, class of 2021. My name is Shristi Chohan.
My name is Jordan Royland.
And my name is Julie Wobe. We're extremely humbled and honored to be your student speakers for the class of 2021 Biology and Biochemistry Virtual Convocation.
We want to begin by thanking the Biology and Biochemistry departments, the Stony Brook University administration, our families, friends, professors, staff, and other mentors who have helped us thrive as students.
We can all agree that college here at Stony Brook University, especially as a STEM major, was difficult enough without a worldwide pandemic. And we're here to remind you that you all have done extraordinary things and have survived an important chapter in your life.
In these past years, we have learned so much. And it wasn't the times we crammed into those Javits 100 seats that we all sat in for some introductory lecture. It wasn't in the recitations or lab class. It wasn't even in the health sciences library cramming for that Orgo 2 or Bio 203 exam.
I'm sure you're wondering what lessons we've learned over these past years. I know everyone watching, peers, professors, family members, and friends, want to know what we've gained.
We'll give you three main takeaways. Firstly, more than the 8 a.m.s, all-nighter crams, and late exams, we will leave here and remember the people. Your time here has exposed you to a rich diversity of individuals from numerous backgrounds and experiences. This world is incredibly complex. There are billions of people, each with millions of traits, conflict and compassion, division and unity. Often we think STEM is separate from identity. Science is objectivity, we tell ourselves, and independent from issues such as social justice and diversity. But this cannot be further from the truth. As I speak to you now, I have antibodies flowing through my blood vessels, thanks to the friendship between two Turkish immigrants to Germany who founded BioNTech and the Greek CEO of Pfizer. I mention this not to laud these individuals for their success in bringing the world out of a pandemic, but for something possibly even greater. Their ability to see one another as more than their country's past conflicts, to value unity and progress over history and division.
After the tragic murder of Breonna Taylor, Ahmaud Arbery, and George Floyd during the summer of 2020, people have finally begun to empathize with their peers and friends who have been met with racism and discrimination their entire lives. The uproar in the fight for social justice is truly inspiring, but we must understand that the fight does not end with a guilty verdict or a sentence by a judge. It ends when one part of a person's identity no longer defines them, when it is no longer probable cause for discrimination or for death. We must continue to recognize our internal biases, amplify the voices of those who are marginalized, and hold aggressors accountable for their actions.
Just as successful mRNA vaccines couldn't be fathomed decades ago, our world is rapidly changing. And what we've learned in the past year is to deal with the uncertainty of change and keep moving forward. It isn't easy to accept that the world sometimes isn't fair. It takes leadership, integrity, and playing your part in the world to accept new changes and uncertainty to come. Class of 2021, if you've proved anything, it's that you aren't afraid of taking on these difficult challenges. Secondly, we have learned much about ourselves and grown through our relationships. I'd like to thank everyone who have been a part of this journey, stuck right beside us through every struggle and hardship we've faced. To say it was easy would not be true. After all the times you've thought about giving up, all the times you've contemplated GPSing class, dropping out a week before graduation, yet here you are, a graduate, and those who did withdraw or took a non-linear path still know that being here today means you made it. You're brave in knowing to put yourself first when you needed to. You have created lifelong relationships and friendships. You have changed and grown every minute of every day into the person you're supposed to be right in this moment. I know I've changed. Relationships formed, past and present, have all defined our time here. I am proud to have seen you become the unique individuals you are today.
We have grown to become independent thinkers, able to question and investigate the world around us for ourselves. But this is not to say that independence is the goal. We learn most with the perspective of those with different experiences, different questions, and different investigations. We should open ourselves to new ideas and also share our ideas with other people.
Thank you to those who saw me through the earlier part of my college journey. Lord knows I was mistaken and hard-headed about many things, but it was through your patience and certainly your impressive arguments that I was able to learn and find truths that I had long ignored around me.
The third and perhaps the most important lesson we've learned during our time here at Stony Brook, especially towards the latter half, is that perseverance is key to success. Despite feeling as if failure was inevitable on that Physics 2 exam, you persevered. Despite feeling like everyone and everything was telling you that you would not achieve your goals, you persevered. Despite all the clamor, pain, and anguish brought about by COVID-19, you persevered. Transferring to Zoom University was not an easy adjustment. Some of us went from never having taken an online course to all of our courses being online. Some of us were forced to leave the environment we cultivated for success and the communities we built for support. But we stayed the course, and nevertheless, we succeeded. Someone once said, the race is not given to the swift, nor the battle to the strong, or in our case, the degree to the smartest, but to the one that endures to the end. Our achievements are not determined by raw talent or aptitude, but by our willingness to pursue our goals, even when faced with obstacles and setbacks.
Class of 2021, be brave. Don't be afraid of change. Do not settle for comfort. Lean into the discomfort. Seek growth within yourself to continue developing into the best version of yourself and more. Make uncertainty your best friend. The road ahead of us is long and challenging. But I'm here to remind you and everyone today that you are strong and resilient enough to get through all the challenges the world has yet to offer.
We want to give you two homework assignments to end this year, a long one and a short one. I'll give you the long one first. For the rest of your lives, keep looking inward to determine who and what groups you've unfairly prejudged. Recognize and commit to changing your preconceptions and actively fighting your implicit biases.
Lastly, find someone at graduation, maybe with a tassel or a stole from something you know nothing about, and talk to them. Really listen to them about their experience and their perspective. And at the end of it, I can only hope this little interaction changes you for the better.
Thank you, class of 2021,
for bettering us in the process
and for being pivotal in our growth.
Congratulations!
My back just cracked at the edge.
That was great.
I
saw you unmuted.
I tried to stall too. Oh.
She's so bad for her being bad.
Beautiful.
Let's get out of here.
Now, my distinct pleasure to recognize the biochemistry and biology graduates of the class of 2021. Each of the graduates who registered to participate in this virtual convocation ceremony will be recognized as their names are read out in alphabetical order.
Ahmad, Abid. Faraz, Abulkader. Abigail, Aki Ampong. Sahar, Alam. Catherine, Alanya. Jack, Amaral. Muhammad, Amin. Navid, Ashrafi. Michael, Awad. Bargov, Ailu. Andrew, Balcarcel. Melissa, Baldio. Lisette, Barreto. Jack, Bauer. Darlene, Beltran. Brianna, Benitez. Harlene, Badia. Jacob, Braham. Carolina, Brulinska. Austin, Budram. Arcel, But. Joyce, Campos. Gia, Carrigan. Bianca, Chandler. Shrishti, Chauhan. Fanny, Chun. Kevin, Chun. Lashine, Chun. Yuseong, Chun. Megan, Cheta. Ryan, Chowdhury. Samira Chowdhury. Shaf Chowdhury. Ariel Connolly. Alejandra Correas Campos. Eric Chui. Gabriella Datilo. Pooja Deshpande. Amy Ding. Gabriella Dominguez. Mira Doshi. Jonin Douglas. Martha Ediel. Danica Emmanuel. Sarah Espinoza. Caitlin Espiritu. Francesca Estevez Garcia. Scott Fiala. Brian Florentino. Dylan Gardner. Imani Gail. Roberta Jeffrard. Jordi Gomez. Justin Goodridge. Alexia Grant. Nina Gu. Jose Guerra. Maria Gura. Caitlin Hahn. Alexandra Hernandez. Lauren Ho. Alima Hossein. Sophia Hu. Alexandra Elasai. Simran Irfan. Nashida Islam. Ananya Iyengar. Miranda Jacobson. Anisha Javaji. Ting Jiang. Yuha Jiang. Xingdu Jean. Alana Zhou. Minu Junkity. Archita Joshi. Turjan Kaber. Amina Cameron. Snigdha Kanadibatla. Ariadne Katsifas. Jocelyn Kaur. Sultan Kaur. Kayla Keenan. Fardin Khan. Nisha Khan. June Young Kim. Elijah King. Darcia Krishnathasan. Patrick Kufluski. Matthew Lee. Zachary Lee. Chong Davidson. Tyler Lee. Emily Lean. Michael Leo. Isabel Loop. Kimberly Lo. Samantha Lo. Julian Ludawan. Suleiman Laa. Axa Mabud. Sydney Mackenzie. Bridget Maxage. Namrota Majunder. Isha Malik. Emma Malone. Brendan Maloney. Samantha Manimala. Jasline Marcella Jana. Julie McGovern Carballo. Nikita Menon. Julia Montero. Justina Monir Henine. Precious Musa. Danya Nomani. Erica Namath. Chinyer Julie Ingwigby. Bridget Nixon. Sachin Patnaik. Emily Peraza. Aditya Persad. Nirmala Persad. Zubair Piperdi. Emily Pribula. Takara Purdy. Silwa Rahil. Fathima Rahman. Erica Rankin. Jordan Royland. Christina Ruiz. Marina Ruzik. Jordan Sahana. Ella Sachs. Anju Sarah Thomas. Dania Sarguro. Shabir Sayar. Nile Sebat. Ariel Shadde. Syed Shah. Esther Shaji. Kiran Sharma. Chodi Sherpa. Eleonora Shin. Michael Seamoys. Krippi Singapuri. Arena Singh. Sydney Sirota. Neha Samanini. Toby Samorin. Nick Sturge. Ariana Sullivan. Shoaib, Syed, Jinrong, Tang, Nathaniel, Changu, Patricia, Tiang, Vishnu, Varma, Ahmad, Wadi, Yvonne, Wong, Thomas, Whitbread, Michelle, Wong, Sebastian, Wozniak, Emily, Wu, Brittany, Yen, Isabel, Yeo, Gauri, Yeramali, Harry, Yoon, Gavin, Yu, Hassan, Yusuf, Risa, Zahidal, Peter, Zeng, Sydney, Zhang, Yuqian, Zheng, Leonardo, Zhou.
Congratulations to all of our graduates. We are now close to the end of the virtual convocation ceremony for the biochemistry and biology graduates of the class of 2021. Before we close, it is important to acknowledge some of the folks that were instrumental in helping to generate our second and hopefully last ever virtual convocation. A student working group comprising biochemistry graduate Nirmala Prasood and biology graduates Danika Emmanuel, Emily Peraza, and Tom Whitbread generated the slideshow that led off today's event. For those of you that missed it or wish to see it again, just hang on, it's coming soon. The compilation of faculty congratulations was produced by biochemistry graduates Yuhi Jiang and Prin Lorpaibunpong. A big shout out to our three student speakers, Shristi Chohan, Julian Wagby, and Jordan Rowland, who were able to stitch together a moving speech. And last but not least, a big thank you to Agosa Okumboa, the communications GA in the biology department, who provided assistance and moral support, most notably for our student speakers. With that, hats off to all of the biochemistry and biology graduates in the class of 2021. Congratulations, you did it.
Congratulations on graduation. Your hard work paid off. Best wishes on your future endeavors. Cheers to an amazing college journey.
Say thank you to my family and my friends, and guys, congratulations, we did it.
I'll Alhamdulillah, we're finally here. I want to thank Mama for being the main reason I'm able to graduate today. I want to thank Papa for always believing in me and Josefa for being the best brother anyone could ever ask for. Lastly, I want to thank Dali, Dada, Naina, all my relatives and friends for helping me grow throughout my time here at Stony Brook. Go Sea Wolves.
My name is Kimberly Liu. I'm a BSMD student. I would like to thank all my professors who taught me so much these past 3 years, especially Dr. Falvich, Dr. Simon, Dr. Singh, Dr. A. Rola, and Dr. Kachoka. Good luck to all 2021 graduates.
Thank you to Anthony, my parents, my friends and family, and all the professors. Congrats, class 2021. We did it.